Hi, I'm Rick.
Hi, I'm Tara.
And welcome to Betty's Kitchen. And we're going to carve a pumpkin today. We're going to try at least. And we did Darth Vader last year, and the year before that we did a scary traditional pumpkin thing with hands on his face. And this year I'm going to try something different. I'm going into uncharted territory here. May work, may not. I've got the scariest TV jacket find, and it's hideous. I apologize for this. There it is.
Three.
First day of school, Carter had his picture taken by his mom as he was walking in, and I'm surprised that he smiled there a little bit. You don't see the enormous backpack he had on his back, but it's a strap. But where do you go to school?
Model.
What grade are you in?
Kindergarten.
Kindergarten, yeah. Last year you were in nursery. So anyway, what I'm going to do is cut this profile out and kind of draw around it. Take a pen or something and kind of put some landmarks in by poking in the corners of places and then kind of freehand draw the rest of it. And then I'm not going to be cutting all the way through the pumpkin where I'm carving the face, because I just want to carve away the lighter areas that will be the light part. They'll transmit more light. The dark areas I just leave solid pumpkin when the rind will be intact. So again, this may or may not work very well. We'll see. Here's a progress report. We've cut the bottom off, and in years past I've cut the top off in a more traditional way, but I like to use a lamp that's wired to electrical house current. You get a lot stronger light through there, and you can vary the light with a light bulb and maybe with the rheostat. But anyway, I cut the bottom out, took out the seeds and the pulp as much as I could, and those are good if you want to toast them and eat them. It's a bit of trouble though. And here's the start. I have cut out the face, put it on, used a pen to mark little holes in the prominent places, and then just gone around with some of my carving tools, wood carving tools, which work wonderfully for this. And got the outline done. I need to do a lot of relief carving on the inner parts now. And I don't know. I don't know how well it's going to work, but we'll see. No. Don't touch. Well, I'm pretty much done with the pumpkin. And I'm wanting to show you, this is a picture that you may recognize. It was the one that started off the slideshow tribute to Betty that was up recently. A lot of comments were made on it. That was when we hadn't been married very long and took a picture. And a few years later, many years later, I took that picture and translated it into a scroll saw portrait of Betty. This is a thin piece of plywood that I made a copy of the picture, scanned the picture, made it black and white, played with the contrast and the brightness, and then just applied it to the piece of plywood and used a scroll saw to cut it out. So that's a 1/8 inch thick piece of wood against a black mat on the back. So that's sort of the technique I was using here. I don't think it worked out as well in this instance. Pumpkins are, I don't know, a little bit different than scroll sawing. Probably I have comments about the carving chisels, so I thought I should show them to you. These are some of the carving chisels that I used. It's a nice, very nice set. Swiss made Feil, P-F-E-I-L, I think, brand of tools. And this is a little chest I made to house them. I've hand chopped the dovetails. And I don't know, I spent a little time on it, but it's very strong. It's a little cobwebby. And works nicely to keep my tools together. Now, as far as the pumpkin. So anyway, it works for a pumpkin. It's a customized jack-o'-lantern. And if you look closely, you might see a resemblance, perhaps. Here's the picture. And here's the jack-o'-lantern. And here's the original. And which one's the better looking? I think so too. But is it good enough?
Carter. Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
They're not the same.